Hi everyone, and welcome to the PlantStock channel. This is Jesse, and tonight I have some excellent news on Beyond Meat. First of all, we're going to take a look at the new partnership between Beyond Meat and Taco Bell and what this could potentially mean for the company. And after that, we're going to take a look at an article that was written yesterday that gives you an idea why it might be a really smart idea to actually buy the stock now and not wait too long. But before we get to it, guys, I would please ask you to subscribe to the channel if you want to continue getting information regarding Beyond Meat and other plant-based companies. And also, I would truly appreciate an early thumbs up since it does help spread the message. Thank you, guys. I appreciate you. And before we get to it, let's just take a look at the stock chart at ticker symbol BYND. And as I'm recording this, the stock market just opened up 2 minutes ago, and it's already up about 6 to 7% and moving on. So it's basically jumped quite a lot now, and it did work quite well yesterday as well. And this is probably related to the recent news that we're going to talk about tonight. So I imagine that most of you are familiar with Taco Bell, and apparently it seems like Taco Bell is going to partner up with Beyond Meat with some kind of vegetarian or vegan menu. And according to the CNBC article, this is kind of a excuse me or I'm sorry to vegetarians, Taco Bell's mea culpa to vegetarians. Potatoes are back and it will test Beyond Meat menu item. Apparently last year, Taco Bell eliminated several items that made a lot of vegetarian consumers pretty unpleased. But starting March 11, the spicy potato soft taco and cheesy fiesta potatoes will be back on their menu. And the Yum Brands chain also announced plans to test a menu item with Beyond Meat's beef substitute. And personally, I am kind of surprised that Taco Bell would have made a move like that, that they take away their vegetarian options in 2020. It seems kind of old-fashioned, giving you an idea that Taco Bell doesn't really seem to know where the trend is heading, right? But that seems to be something they realized and now they're changing it. So in an effort to try to redeem themselves, they're partnered up with Beyond Meat. But little information is given as of yet. As is stated in the article, quote, in another appeal to vegetarian customers, Taco Bell plans to test an item made with a Beyond Meat vegetarian substitute this year. For now, Taco Bell is staying tight-lipped on how it will be used. I would say that it's going to be unique to the things that you've seen elsewhere, so we're definitely going to put our Taco Bell innovation and spin on it, Matthew said. So this does sound really encouraging, and looking at Taco Bell, they actually have about 7,000 restaurants that serve more than 40 million customers each week in the U.S., and internationally, the brand is growing with nearly 500 restaurants across almost 30 countries across the globe. What could this mean for Beyond Meat? Well, as we said, there's limited information as of yet, but if they would be put on the 7,000 restaurants they have, that would be amazing for Beyond Meat's revenue, obviously. But logically, I think initially it will be listed to a few on a trial basis. But the potentials are still there, which could lead to, like we talked about, massive gains for Beyond in long term. We just have to wait and see. And I think this is exciting news nonetheless. Guys, let me know. What do you feel and think about this? And let's move on to the other article that was released yesterday. And it's talking about that Beyond Meat is down about 40%. Quote, shares of Beyond Meat peaked back in October as well at $197.50 per share. At the time, the stock was riding high after a series of announcements, including expanded distribution, global expansion, and then new product launches. But like most of us know, because it seemed like McDonald's aren't partnering up with Beyond Meat, at least not as a brand item, a lot of investors probably took this as a bad sign and started selling off. What I like about this particular article is that the author does seem to share a lot of the same visions that I see for Beyond Meat. That no matter what, even if it is true, and we don't know that as of yet, that McDonald's and Beyond Meat won't be partnering up right now, it doesn't mean that there's not a lot of things to look forward to. We already know that in 2020, the company launched new products like breakfast sausage. And they also started expanding into China with a new pork version of their Beyond Meat. And apparently also expanded into Brazil. In the coming year, this could create a lot more revenue. But something I've talked about a lot about in this channel is that when Beyond Meat starts lowering their prices of their product, when it becomes cheaper than actual meat, we'll see a huge game changer. And this is something that the author of this article also emphasizes on. Quote, however, the thing I'm looking forward to the most with Beyond Meat is something called price parity. Management has set the goal of getting its product prices below traditional animal protein in the next couple of years. Right now, it's Beyond Burger is the closest. Its price per pound was down 7% year over year in the third quarter, and I expect prices to get closer as the company keeps scaling production. And once plant-based meat is actually cheaper than normal beef, it could spark fresh revenue growth from first-time customers just looking to save some money. And in my opinion, he's understating this fact. This, again, is going to change everything. If this becomes cheaper than ordinary meat, traditional meat, people will start to flock to buy Beyond Meat's products. There's no doubt in my mind. When you look at studies that has been done in my country, Sweden, it's been quite obvious that every time the meat prices are higher, people tend to go vegetarian or vegan much more, or that they choose to eat a lot less meat and try to find those alternative meat products. Because not everyone wants to just eat beans and lentils to begin with anyways, right? So people want to find that transition food that reminds them of meat, that comfort food, what they're used to, and Beyond Meat will be perfectly placed for that. And continuing with the article, quote, many see lower prices from Beyond Meat as a bad thing, assuming profit margins are getting decimated. In reality, they're holding strong. Through the first three quarters of 2019, Beyond Meat's gross profit margin was 33%. By comparison, in the same period of 2020, its gross profit margin was almost 32% and was hurt by the pandemic. As you can see, the company is lowering prices in harmony with production improvements, mitigating this concern for now. So I don't know about you guys, but personally, I feel this article kind of puts it together. This is what I've been talking about for a long time. Guys, if you want to make money with Beyond Meat, you got to go long term. Now, sure, there's other companies out there and there are other plant stock companies out there where you could make some fast money. But long term, guys, this is where you want to go, in my opinion. It has the brand name globally. It's at 112,000 stores all over the world. And Ethan Brown has a clear-cut vision. He wants to change the planet. He's going to do everything he can to cut costs so you'll get a product that's cheaper than meat. Guys, again, I know I sound like a broken record, but it's a game changer. Guys, let's have some interaction again. Let me know what you feel about it. What do you think about this? All right, guys, that was it for today. I really hope you got some value with today's video. And if you did, please smash that like button. And if you want to be part of this family and keep getting information regarding plant-based food, regarding Beyond Meat, then please subscribe to the channel. And as always, guys, this is not financial advice. These are just my own thoughts and opinions. You need to do with them as you please. But please, guys, invest safe. Do your own due diligence. Hope to see you soon. Peace out.